For the climate. The climate in Ukraine is mild European climate. It means that there are no high temperatures in summer and no low temperatures in winter. Now we have like the middle of the summer and the temperature is rise not higher than 29-30 degrees. So for local people it is rather hot. For you I think it is rather comfortable, and the climate is mostly dry, and now it is summer, and starting from middle of September, October and November, autumn comes, the temperature goes down. It can be like 20, 15 degrees above zero. So then winter comes. It is November, it is December, November, December, January and February, sorry. So this time can be rather cold, for example, comparing to winter. The temperature goes below zero. Usually it is like 0 degrees, plus 2, minus 5. Sometimes it is -10, -12 degrees. So the snow comes, and but all the buildings, or exceptionally all the buildings in our country, they are equipped with heating, central heating, and it is warm. If it is cold outdoors, indoors, it is warm, and just people can wear their everyday clothes. But for going outside, people need like warm boots, jackets, hats, sweaters, scarves, and so warm, rather warm clothes. But speaking about our students, there is no need for them to stay out for a long time, for example, because most of buildings of the university inside the campus, they are situated like 2 or 3 minutes walk. So it there is no time to be frozen like this. So after winter, March, April and May, spring comes. This is the period of vegetation for growing crops. So as for the food in Ukraine, so all kind of food is possible there. Part of people are vegetarians, part of people are not vegetarians, but all kinds of fruits and vegetables are possible to get in Ukraine all over the world. We also grow such vegetables as potatoes, onions, carrots, aubergines, cabbages, so all this is available, like fruits, like apples, plums, pears, peaches, they are also grown in Ukraine. Bananas we don't grow, it is rather cold country for them, but all of these fruits and vegetables, so they are available in the markets, at the at the supermarkets of Ukraine, all over the world. So now a couple of words about Vinnitsa city. Vinnitsa city is the center for Vinnitsa region. Ukraine is divided into 24 regions, and Vinnitsa is the center of one of them. This is a rather big region. Mainly this is an agricultural place, but most of people live in towns and cities. So the city is old. It was founded more than 600 years ago, and during 3 years the national surveys show that Vinnitsa is the most comfortable city in Ukraine to live in. Not the capital, but Vinnitsa is. The crime rate is very low. It is safer for local people, for foreigners. to go out in every place all over the city. It is open, it is free, everyone can go there. The people are friendly in Vinnitsa, so not only medical university trains the foreign students. We have large polytechnic university, and it also has a lot of foreign students who comes who come to Vinnitsa to study. And local people, they know that these young people who differ from them, they are students. They come here to study, and usually their attitude is very friendly. Our National Pirogov Memorial Medical University was founded in 1921, so very soon we are going to be 100 years old. During this time, the university has gained great experience in teaching students. When the USSR split in 1991, we turned to Europe, Ukraine turned to Europe, but we don't reject all good experience that we had during Soviet Union. So our system of education, that medical education in particular, is like combination of old Soviet Union school with great practice, with a lot of practice, practical work for students, and the system of European universities. And I think that this is our good results. It gives good results in teaching students, and we can see that our students are good students, and they get good jobs, and they have good promotion in the world when they come back to the university, to their countries. So the university trains students from 1978. Again, it was, I address to the parents, they remember the times when Soviet Union helped, for example, India in training like specialists, doctors. And in Soviet Union there was only three universities that trained doctors from India in particular. And Vinnitsa National Medical University was only one of them. Two of other were in Russia, and in Ukraine there was only one, our university, who started training foreign students from that time. From 1990s, the university teaches in English. So the teachers, the lecturers, the professors of the university, they know English. They know English well. English is not a native language for us. Our language is native language is Ukrainian. But all of them, all our teachers, our professors, they are experienced workers. They work for many years, and they know how to communicate with the students, how to conduct lectures. It is very interesting to visit their lectures. They have, the university is equipped with computers, multimedia, and so the students have different opportunities to get the information from during the studying process. So not only students from India, foreign students from India study in our university, there are students from Asian countries, from African countries, and sometimes the students are mixed in groups. For example, there are two or three people, guys from Namibia, two or three students from Nigeria, two or three students from India, two or three students from Morocco, for example. And our experience as dean's workers, we can say that students study better in international groups, not only when 10 students are from one country, from India. So when the students are from different countries, certainly they are friends between themselves. They speak in English, they speak the same language, they spend much time together, they help each other, but there is some competition between them. And As a result of this competition, certainly it is good competition for good marks, for better behavior, for everything, and this gives good opportunities for students to show themselves, and they, as a result, the average marks in the groups are better, the results, the success of the progress of students is better. So the course of study at the university lasts for 6 years. It corresponds to the requirements of World Health Organization and requirements of European Union universities. So they consider that during this time, 6 years, a young personality can become a real specialist. The course of study of 6 years, it is divided into two parts by 3 years. First 3 years, the students study preclinical subjects. As Dr. Anil has mentioned, it is anatomy, histology, microbiology, physiology, pathologic physiology, so all range of medical preclinical subjects. But besides this, we are a university. We are a European university, and the student who enters a university, not a college, it's not a workshop, it is a university, it is a European university, and the task of the university is to educate not a worker, but a specialist, a personality. That is why the students at the university study philosophy, they study history. They study history like general history, they study history of medicine, they study psychology, they study like economical sciences. So everything that makes the horizons of the personality wider, and what makes any person personality, not only a person but personality. So these subjects are also taught at the university during a preclinical course of study, but still, the main subjects for a student are anatomy, histology, physiology, pathologic physiology, microbiology, biochemistry, biophysics. So the students are concentrated, and most of academic hours have these subjects. The students during first years, they are also study local language of Ukraine. It is Ukrainian language. So first of all, because the students are going to spend 6 years in this country, it will be necessary for them to communicate with local people. Then, starting when their medical practice starts, the students will come to real hospitals. They will come in touch with real patients, and not much local population, they can speak English. That is why the students have to know Ukrainian, just to know to ask about the complaints of the patient, to ask to prescribe some diagnosis, and the patient must also understand it. So that is why the students study Ukrainian. But Ukrainian, again, I tell you, we understand that this is not the main subject for a student. This is just fun for students. Students like these classes of Ukrainian because all the teachers are friendly. For example, I am a teacher of Ukrainian. I work with students from India. I teach them Ukrainian, and all of them just like me. Then this is preclinical course of study.